Imagine a world where the very laws of space are a lie. A world where a straight line is not the shortest distance between two points, where parallel lines can meet, and where doorways can lead to places that are not just far away, but fundamentally, elsewhere. Sounds like a paradox, doesn't it? For the architects of cosmic horror, this wasn't just a nightmare, it was a weapon. It was a key to unlocking a new kind of fear, and a foundational element of their terrifying new genre. Before we descend into madness, let's get a quick handle on the concept. For over 2,000 years, our reality was governed by Euclidean geometry, the simple, elegant rules we all learned in school. A triangle's angles always add up to 180 degrees. Parallel lines march side by side into infinity, never touching. It's the comfortable, predictable geometry of our homes, our cities, and our minds. It feels like an unbreakable law of the universe. But what if it's just a local ordinance? Enter non-Euclidean geometry. It's the simple, terrifying idea that space can be curved. Think of the surface of a globe. If you draw two parallel lines of longitude from the equator, they will inevitably meet at the poles. A giant triangle drawn between continents will have angles that add up to more than 180 degrees. That's spherical geometry. Then there's its twisted cousin, hyperbolic geometry, an even more alien concept where space curves outward like a saddle, and a triangle's angles add up to less than 180. These aren't just theories, they are mathematically sound descriptions of how reality can behave in ways our senses were never designed to perceive. So, how do we, as three-dimensional beings, even begin to comprehend this? A compelling analogy can be found in a Victorian novella called Flatland. It tells the story of A Square, a two-dimensional being who lives in a world of lines and shapes, unable to conceive of a third dimension. To him, height is a nonsensical concept. Now imagine a sphere from our world passing through Flatland. What would a square see? Not a sphere. He would see a circle that appears out of nowhere, magically expands in size, and then shrinks back to a point before vanishing completely. His two-dimensional mind is fundamentally incapable of perceiving the sphere's true, three-dimensional form. He would dismiss it as a miracle or madness. This serves as a potent metaphor for humanity within these tales of cosmic horror. The protagonists are the Flatlanders, and the creatures and places they encounter are the sphere. When they witness wrongly angled architecture or beings whose forms shift and refuse to resolve into anything logical, their minds are breaking against the hard shores of a higher dimensional reality. The horror isn't just seeing a monster, it's the sudden, maddening realization that your entire perception of the universe is a flawed, incomplete illusion. This is where the unique power of cosmic horror becomes clear. The characters aren't just fighting monsters, they are standing inside the paradox, and it's breaking their minds. A prime example is the nightmare corpse city of Arlie from the classic tale, The Call of Cthulhu. The description of the city is highly effective at creating cosmic dread. It's a panorama of angles and stone surfaces, but these surfaces are all wrong. It is filled with a strangeness which did not suggest any natural thing. Imagine trying to navigate a city built by architects for whom up is just a suggestion. A staircase might lead you back to where you started. A hallway could feel like it's stretching into infinity even as you walk its length. A doorway could be visibly smaller than you are, yet you could pass through it with ease. This isn't just disorienting, it's a full frontal assault on your sanity. The creatures that inhabit these spaces, like Great Cthulhu itself, are described with the same impossible, protean forms, their very existence a violation of the laws of biology and physics. So why is this so terrifying? It goes deeper than just weird shapes. The horror of non-Euclidean geometry is the horror of collapsed certainty. Our brains are hardwired for Euclidean space. It is a fundamental subconscious expectation. When we see something that brazenly defies these rules, it triggers a deep primal alarm. It's not a jump scare. It's a slow, creeping intellectual dread. It's the feeling that the universe is not just bigger and stranger than you imagined, but that it is fundamentally unintelligible. The monster isn't just the creature in the shadows. The monster is the shadow itself, the very fabric of space that refuses to obey the rules. It becomes a kind of cosmic gaslighting where the universe itself is telling you that you are insane. While Relier is a famous example, these spatial distortions were woven throughout the broader mythos. In At the Mountains of Madness, the cyclopean cities of the Elder Things, with their bizarre five-pointed structures, hint at a mastery of geometry far beyond our own. Humans can observe them, but could never hope to build them. The use of non-Euclidean geometry in these stories was revolutionary. The genre took abstract, high-level mathematics and transformed it into a visceral, mind-shattering tool for horror. It gives the understanding that the most potent fears aren't about death or pain, but about the loss of comprehension, the terror of becoming a flatlander in a universe full of spheres. Its influence is everywhere today, a reminder that the most effective horrors aren't always the ones we can see and fight. They are the ones we can barely perceive, the ones that hint at the chilling possibility that our reality is just a thin, fragile membrane stretched over an abyss of beautiful, terrifying, and impossible truths.